About this time of year, all the family used to get down to me Nanny Paul's in Portway Road, Albury. Now, what used to happen at Nanny Paul's, if you just had a bab, if you're ready to have a bab, you'd go back to me Nanny Paul's, and my Auntie Frieda used to board most of the babbies, you see. And so you'd go back to Nanny Paul's and you'd stop there until you'd had the bab, and then for a few months after, till you're back on your feet and my mother was back working the lathes. Or if one of your one of the wenches, they were due, you'd have to get out and the next one would come in and you'd have to find somewhere else to live. Well, I settled already on Cape Moor Estate, so we just had our gazza, and so we'd been at Nanny Paul's, and it was probably about early December, and then I think it was my Auntie Glad was going to have our Freddie, so it was her turn to come in. So we went and lived at Nanny Dakin's, which was just up by Mount Farm School for a bit. But the big one was still at Rounds Green, you see, so we had to go down every day. Anyway, we went back down to me nan's. And then on Saturdays, everybody had grouped together. And this particular Saturday, I think everybody got together to make the plans for Christmas. So there was probably 30 of us there with all my cousins and that. It was great for me because we went out in the fold and we were all playing. The blokes went off to the Traveller's Rest to wet the wazins. And all the wenches started to cook the fiddle or the broth with me nana. Well, the blokes come back, and the order of service was the blokes would eat first, then the babs, and then while the wenches were having the fiddle, the blokes would wash the crocks up and then go out in the fold of the brewers and have a fake. And then the day would go on and we'd plan it, and then everybody would get together, my dad, my Uncle Bill and my Uncle Eric would start to sing and everybody would sing. So we were all sat there and singing away and everybody was joining in. And Nana Paul come in from the brewers and says, it's starting to snow. And my mother looked up and he said, Kath, I will get the bab back home because if this sticks and it looks as though it's going to stick, I'm going to struggle to get back up to Mount Farm. So my father says to my mum, well, you take the big one and the bab in the pram with your mum and dad and I'll stop a bit and I'll bring Billy back a bit later on. So my mother, they packed him up, put the kilts on, got them ready, and off they went, back to Langley. And my dad was finishing his beer, and him and Uncle Eric and Uncle Bill was singing along, and everybody was enjoying it. About an hour went by, and Nana come back in, and they said, Dave, I think you should be ready to go now. Says, it's starting to stick now, and it's pretty thick, and the wind's getting up, and it's a-drifting. So my granddad went and got me coat, and he tied me up, put a scarf round, put me cap on, my dad put his overcoat on. And by the time we got out the front door, it was quite deep. And it was coming down in sheets and sheets and sheets. And my father says, oh no, we'll go along the cut up Tack Bank, and then we can come through Mount Farm, that road. So we got onto Church Beach, down the towpath, and started going. Nobody had been down the towpath. Well, I was only a little bab, and the snow was coming up here, and he says, yeah, I'm struggling a bit, are you, bab? And I said, I am, Dad. He says, well, come up here. And he lifted me up onto the back on his shoulders. And I took my legs under his armpits here and off we went. Just as we were coming up Tack Bank way, this bloke was coming the other road. It was one of the chaps that worked the wheels, my father. And he says, what you doing, Dave? He says, well, I've been down my mother-in-law's and all the rest of them have gone now. I'm just getting back home now to Mount Farm. He says, well, mind how you go, because Langley's covered now. And up by the park, there's big drifts. So they said the ta-ras and off we went. And I could feel my dad breathing heavier. And I could feel the heat coming through his coat on the backs of my legs. We got down the bottom of Barnford Park and the parkie was there. He says, all right, Dyke, how are you doing? He says, well, I've walked all the road from Albury. He says, and I'm going to get the bab back home now because it's pretty bad. He says, well, I've left the gate at the bottom is open and the gate at the top, because I know some folks would want to take the shortcut. So if you're going to go that way, it saves you going all the road round. Anyway, we started going through the park and he was really trudging now and I could feel a sweat coming off his brow. And he said, son, I'm going to take you somewhere now. I says, where, Dad? He says, we're going up top of Pudding Rock. I says, what are we going up there for? He says, I want to show you something. Anyway, we get to the bottom of Pudding Rock and he starts to lean into it so we can get up and all in back, otherwise I'd have gone straight over in the snow. And we get up the top of Pudding Rock and we're facing Moat Road. He says, now I'm going to turn around and I want you to see a wonderful sight. And he turned me round and there in front of me in the valley were Albury, covered in this ermine coat. And the flickering of the lights from all of the settles and the flickering of the factory furnaces. But the thing that got me most to know was you don't hear nothing. You don't hear the pounding of the mills. You don't hear any of the hustle of the bustle down in the streets. It was complete and utter silence. And I just sat there for a minute and I started to take all this beauty in about how everything had gone down to almost nothing. He says, "What does it feel like, son?" He says, and I says, "It's like I'm sat on the shoulder of a giant, Dad." He says, "It's funny you should say that. Because I come with your granddad when I was your age. And a similar night to this. And we see exactly the same sight. And all the beauty of the town covered in white snow." And we stood there for a minute. And right in the distance, faint, you could just hear the choir from the Green Street Chapel singing. Silent night, fires burn bright, moon hangs low in an aubry sky, cuts through Dover, it looks like Christy. Down in Lowtown, the chapel bells peal. The crowd it gathers around Christmas Eve in Aubrey Town. Silent night, rowley banks wide, see the joy in the babby's eyes. Choirs around the cenotaph, all them singing the hallelujahs. Crowd it gathers around Christmas Eve in Aubrey Town. You know this verse. Silent night, howling night, all is calm, all is bright, round the young virgin mother and child, holy infant so tender and mild, sleep in the heavenly peace, sleep in heavenly peace. It's like a sot on the shoulder of a giant.